Hey there, all my little physics maniacs. C-Car here. I just want to work through the details of how do I go about drawing a good motion diagram to help me solve a kinematics problem. And I'm not even going to solve this here. Maybe I'll put an answer in the comments if you want to check. But I want to focus right now on the setup of how do I turn this paragraph into a problem that I can solve. And so my first step, always, I'm going to draw a motion diagram. Let's just take a minute to read what we're doing here. So, okay, I'm driving 20 meters per second. That's about 45 miles an hour, which is too fast in a 35 mile an hour zone. Light turns yellow. I'm 35 meters away from the intersection. I slam on the brakes because I wasn't paying attention well enough. And I slow down steadily at 6 meters per second each second. And I want to know, hey, do I come to a stop before I get into the intersection? So I've drawn a little traffic signal here, the light's yellow, and so let's say I'm just going to imagine that I'm driving to the right, so I'll draw my car over here to start out, a little sombrero mobile there, and to make my motion diagram, I'm just going to represent the car as a dot. I'll just use a dot right at the front bumper of the car, because it's the front bumper of the car that I care about, will it get into the intersection. So, oh, and I also know then that it's 35 meters from the starting point of my car to that intersection. So, I think what I'm going to be trying to do then, do I manage to stop before entering the intersection? I'm going to figure out how far does my car travel, and then compare it with 35 meters, see what happens. Hopefully then I'll travel a distance less than 35 meters by the time I come to a stop. So to make my motion diagram, my car is here at some initial time. So I'm just going to say that t equals 0 at the moment when I hit the brakes. So this is a time of 0 seconds. And let's see, my car is going forwards, but it's getting slower and slower and slower. So my motion diagram, if I imagine these dots, then it should be getting, as my car goes forward, say, in one amount of time, the next amount of time, it shouldn't go as far forwards. And so my dots should be getting closer and closer and closer together, maybe like so. That was a little optimistic, but let's see, it looks to me pretty much like, okay, these dots keep getting closer together, so I'll go with it. And hopefully I do stop that far ahead, although the driver behind me might not like that. Now, I can see then that my car was going forwards pretty fast at the start, and then not quite as fast, and then not quite as fast, and then not quite as fast. And then by the time it got here, well, the next dot would be right there because now it's at a stop, so, you know, like the next whole bunch of dots would all be right there. So I can see, and I've drawn these little arrows like representing velocity, so I've got velocities this way that are getting smaller. Now, before I can really go any further, I need to just think about how I want to think about numbering. I want to think about my positive direction as being this way, so we can think about the car traveling forwards. So I'm just going to imagine positive direction then is going this way to the right. So time to settle on some numbers. excuse me. I'm thinking, okay, so the first dot of the car is this one. So at this dot, then I want to think about, out of all the variables that I might care about, I've got amount of time, I've got acceleration, starting velocity, ending velocity, I've got starting position, ending position. So I know I can identify starting position and starting velocity being right here. And so that starting velocity, I know from reading the question, I was, before I slowed down, going 20 meters per second. So this red arrow here would be 20 meters per second that way. And the position, well, I can set positions to be wherever I like. So just thinking about, like, where do I want, like, the zero of my measuring to be? Let's say, oh, right here, I want the zero position to be right there. So X for position, X naught for the starting position. So I can decide I want that to be zero because I can make it be whatever I want. Now, I can then find at this very last dot, hopefully the position of this last dot is going to be something less than 35 meters, but I don't know that yet. And that's the thing I want to find out. What is this ending position? Is it less than 35 meters? Now, I also know, at this very, very last dot right here, I also know something about the velocity of the car there. And I didn't write the number here, but I do know that by the time I come to a stop, you know, did I manage to stop before entering the intersection? So, if you've ever driven a car, surely you know that you stop at red lights. So, here, at this very, very last dot, I know that the velocity is going to have to be zero. So, by thinking about first dot, last dot, now I've managed to identify a couple of my variables. Now, if you're not in honors physics, but you're in regular physics, then you're not using x's. But what you would be doing then, if you're in regular physics, is you would be thinking, okay, from here to here, what's that d? So we're doing the same thing, whether you're honors or regular. Honors, we're using the x's for position, or regular, you're just looking at d for displacement. Now, let's see. I do have more information here, and I know that I don't yet have enough information to solve this. So there is something else, and here, this last sentence on top. When I hit the brakes, I slowed down at a steady rate of 6 meters per second which I know then I can also write that as 6 meters per second squared. I just wrote it this way just to help us focus on the meaning of velocity decreases by 6 meters per second every second I'm hitting the brakes. Now, I need to think carefully, though, about the sign for my acceleration. This is a common mistake people make. They think, oh, slowing down means negative acceleration, speeding up means positive acceleration. But we know that that's not always true. So we need to think carefully about how do I decide on the sign. And the way that I decide on the sign is we know that acceleration is about how is velocity changing. The definition of acceleration is change in velocity over that time interval. So we have to think about how is the velocity changing. Now, it's because the sign of this acceleration comes down to the choice I made right here about the positive direction is this way. And that's why I know that this velocity initially was a positive number. That's a plus sign. I'm doing it badly. But this is a positive number here. So the velocity was positive 20 meters per second. Now we know that this is slower. So the next velocity is going to be some positive number that's less than 20, some positive number that's less than 20, some less than the number before it, some positive number, and these positive numbers are getting smaller. Now, what kind of change do we have when we're decreasing positive numbers? If I go, say, after 1 second, I'll be moving 20 minus 6, 14 meters per second. After 2 seconds, minus another 6, then I'll be going 8 meters per second. So the changes in velocity are negative. So in 1 second, I'm losing negative. I'm losing 6 meters per second of velocity. So I could write that acceleration as negative 6 meters per second. And I think it's really important that we recognize that this acceleration isn't negative because it's slowing down. It's negative because of the combination of slowing down, and I chose that these velocities are all positive numbers. There are situations where slowing down matches up with a positive acceleration, and vice versa. Anyway, now, if we think about a list of what are all the different variables that I might actually care about, if we're in honors physics, then that would be starting and ending position, starting and ending velocity, acceleration, time. If you're in regular physics, then that would be that displacement d, starting velocity, ending velocity, acceleration, time. And again, remember, we're assuming that time starts at 0 seconds right here. And so now it's a matter of, okay, we make a list, and let's see, the variables that I know. I know starting and ending positions, I know starting and ending velocities, I know the acceleration. So, what I'm looking for here is the equation that I'm going to need to solve this is I'm going to use the one that doesn't have time in it. I'm going to use the one that has all these other ones in it. And so now that I've used this diagram to help me figure out what my numbers are and get their signs correct, I mess up the signs, I'm going to mess up an answer. So then I know that the equation that I need is this one. Or if you're in regular physics one, that it would be same equation except we would have a D there, I think. But now I know what equation I'm using because I know, okay, I've got all of these variables, I don't have time, and so this is how the diagram helps me know what variables I'm working with. The diagram helps me get it, helps me get these signs correct, this is positive, that's negative, etc. And so now I can do a piece of algebra, I can substitute these numbers in, and then I'm going to solve it. You want to check an answer, then check the comments. I'll see you later.